The Philippine Bureau of Corrections may not be your first choice to push for self-sufficiency in terms of rice, but the agency is doing its part to help the country's food security. Now, Prisons Chief Director General Gregorio Catapang Jr. recently announced programs that aims to help the national government stabilize rice supply. And Catapang is doing this by turning some land of penal farms to rice fields, with persons deprived of liberty assisting in making this a reality. To tell us more about the RICE project, or the Reformation Initiative for Sustainable Environment for Food Security of the BuCor and other concerned agencies, we are joined in Top Story by Director General Catapang himself. Good afternoon, General Catapang, and welcome to Top Story.
Yes, magandang hapon din po sa inyong lahat at sa mga tagapakinig ninyo.
Okay, I'd like to talk about the rice availability first in Muntinlupa. There has been a program where cheaper rice have been made available in Muntinlupa, including the Bilibid prisons. Today, tell us about that distribution.
Today, we were able to bring in about 100 sacks of rice, and about 30 or 80 sacks of rice were bought by the residents of Muntinlupa.
Okay.
At maganda naman ang aming accommodation doon sa lugar.
And how much are you selling the rice for?
It's 44 pesos per kilo.
Okay, so that's really lower, no? Mas mababa siya than the current market price. You have other programs as well. Other penal colonies are now supposed to help stabilize rice supply through planting. How do you envision to sustain this, sir?
Of course, yung itong Muntinlupa, we have about 350 hectares.
Okay.
No? And we're now planting it with the vegetables. And then, of course, yung mga PDL naman natin, they are the ones producing it. And they are selling it sa Kadiwa pop-up store.
Okay.
So, at aming mga kaibigan naman sa Bulacan and Pampanga, they've they dinadala ni BuCor.
Okay. Okay, now nagkakatulungan nga, no, because you have been replicating, or you will be replicating, these projects all over the country. In Iwahig, there is also a similar initiative. Now, are PDLs enjoying certain privileges in exchange for the service they provide, or perhaps compensation?
Yeah,
we seem to be getting a bad connection with General Catapang. We'll try to call you back, sir, as soon as we get a better line. Moving on, the Philippine military suspects Chinese militia vessels are behind the harvesting of corals in Rozul Reef. Located inside the country's exclusive economic zone, now officials say there are no corals left in the area. Victoria Tulad tells us more.
Vice Admiral Alberto Carlos, commander of the AFP Western Command, said they observed coral harvesting in Rozul Reef, also known as Iroquois, sometime last July. Rozul is part of the exclusive economic zone in the Philippines in the West Philippine Sea. The AFP suspects Chinese military militia vessels to be behind this, since they were the ones stationed in the area before the AFP was able to drive them away. Carlos said no corals were left in the area, and to their untrained eye, it seemed as if the harvesting happened recently. The AFP officials said activity is alarming because China is violating the sovereign rights of the Philippines. He emphasized that Filipinos should be the ones to enjoy the resources in the country's EEZ. It is also alarming because he says it might seem that the AFP is remiss in its duty in protecting the West Philippine Sea. Colonel Medel Aguilar, AFP spokesman, added that coral harvesting is a threat to the food security, not just of the Philippines, but of the world. Carlos said they are increasing their presence in the area and encouraging their allies to take action that will result in favorable condition on the ground. Another issue is the swarming activity in the contested waters. As of last night, 40 Chinese vessels were reported in Rozul Reef. In a statement yesterday, Westcom said there were also 5 Chinese vessels in Escoda Shoal and 2 in Barangatan Bank as of early September. Carlos said they are addressing the problem by putting forces there. There are continuous efforts to file diplomatic protests against China, But as to filing another case in an international court, he says there's still no decision.
Officials representing Surigao del Norte are calling on the Philippine military and the United States to look at the province as a possible site that can be used for the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA. Representative Robert Ace Barber says ships can travel the country from east to west and vice versa without the need to circle around. Now, Barber adds the province offers a very strategic advantage. Another official or governor, Lyndon Barber, says the EDCA site in their province will also benefit the whole eastern regions of the Visayas and Mindanao, particularly in times of calamities, since aid can be delivered faster. The U.S. military has announced they are looking for more EDCA sites. Let's continue our discussion with Prisons Chief Director General Gregorio Catapang Jr. Good afternoon again, sir. We were cut off a while ago.
Yeah, I'm sorry for the cut off. Okay, na po.
Okay, so you're joining us by phone now. Sir, we left off with a discussion on the PDL involved in rice planting and rice production and agriculture activities in a lot of your penal colonies. We'd like to know if they will be paid or if they will be given certain privileges.
Yeah, that will come in. Pag nagtanim sila, they'll be paid minimum wage, so-called, or whatever is made available, may bayad sila.
Okay.
And then, of course, meron pa silang GCTA or good conduct, which will help them earn more points or liberties. No, bawa, ngayong araw na to, nag-work sila. Imbis na one day lang yung count ng kanilang service, it will become 2 days. So, mapapabilis yung paglaya pa nila. Dalawang beses sila mabibiyayaan, mababayaran na sila sa trabaho nila. At the same time, mapapabilis pa yung paglaya nila.
Okay. Sir, is this something that is mandatory to everyone, or are you selecting particular PDLs who are more knowledgeable or more capable of handling the farms?
Yeah, many of the PDLs are farmers. Kaya nila.
Okay.
And then, of course, nandiyan naman yung Department of Agriculture. That's part of their reformation program and their parang vocational program para matuto sila ng panibagong hanap buhay if they are not farmers. Kasi I think they'll still stay with us mga 5 to 6 years or 10 years more. So magagamit sila. They can be made productive while staying in prison.
Okay, General Catapang, let's talk about another subject here, the supposed fake memorandum ordering the transfer of inmates. Do we have any persons or suspects in mind who may be behind this move?
Of course, yung nga, nasabi na ni Secretary Boyeng Rimulya na ang ano dyan is who will benefit from that fake memo.
Okay.
Sino nakita ko, sinadala sa amin, tumakbo kagad ako sa office ni Secretary Rimulya. Sabi ko, Sod, totoo ba ito? Napirmahan mo ba ito? Sabi niya, hindi totoo yan.
Okay.
Ako rin, sabi ko, hindi totoo yan kasi ang utos mo sa akin, ilipat sila lahat sa sa safer area and then doon sila dalhin sa Mindoro. So I doubt wala ka namang verbal instruction sa akin baguhin yung order. So
okay.
I had to have a face-to-face meeting with the secretary and clarify this thing. So talagang fake yan, fake memo yan, boss.
Okay, it's kind of severe and concerning though, considering the fact that these are 12 high-profile inmates and there's talk about them being taken to Muntinlupa. What's the possible scenario here? What are you looking at?
Of course, nawalan kasi sila ng mga privileges eh. Doon sa Muntinlupa, they can move around, they can may mga sarili silang cellphone na naitatago, no?
Okay.
But and then of course, alam naman natin nagkaroon ng konting gulo sa Muntinlupa. I want them to be safe for their safety. So napilitan ako talaga ilipat sila sa Mindoro because they are safer doon sa lugar.
Okay. And also, is there any reason to believe that this is something to do with the case of former Senator Leila De Lima, particularly her drug case?
Oh, wala naman. Kasi formerly, they were staying dyan sa military camps. And then for the longest time, naubos na yung aming agreement with the DND. So I was instructed by Secretary Limulya. Sabi niya, DG, kunin mo na yung mga inmates natin o PDLs natin na naka-assign dyan sa Marines at saka sa ISAF. Because expired na yung ating agreement. And I want to show to the to our countrymen na kaya naman ng ating bantayan yung mga yan.
Okay.
Hindi naman kailangan pahirapan natin yung military na babantayan sila. So, better dito sa atin. So, na-decide namin sa dadalhin sila sa Mindoro for their safety and security.
Okay. Sir, this is a case quite concerning, the fact that at the very least this is a forgery of the Justice Secretary's signature. People should be made accountable for this. Heads must roll. In fact, the National Bureau of Investigation is already conducting, if anything, its own probe. When do you expect results to be out?
We are all nagkakandak kami ng sarili naming investigation, and then we'll submit it to NBI. And then if NBI would want to come to our premises and investigate kung paano ba yan naipasok dito sa lugar namin o sa portal namin, we are very much willing to allow them to investigate here in BuCor.
Mm-hmm. All right. Lastly, sir, perhaps you can give us, or can you give us, an update on other possible reforms following the recent dismantling of kubols at the beloved prisons?
Ang next na order sa akin ni Secretary Limulya is to have a cashless prison colony. Mangyayari niyan na their relatives can still send money to them, although ang usapan dyan, 2,000 per week or 8,000 per month.
Mm-hmm.
But as soon as they want to give money, meron kaming BuCor trading post or trust fund. We will convert their money nila na pinadala to coupon. So they will just transact cashless. Sa ganun, namo-monitor natin yung perang pumapasok. Because sometimes the money is the root cause of mga illegal transactions dyan sa loob.
Okay. Thank you so much for joining us, Philippine Prisons Chief General Gregorio Catapang Jr. Maraming salamat po.
Maraming salamat din po sa pagkakataon.